Welcome to tutorialsinhand.com. In this video tutorial, we are going to see what is the importance of or purpose of making string immutable. In the last video tutorial, we have already learned why string is said to be immutable in Java. So now we are going to check what is the purpose behind making the string immutable. So first purpose is that it helps. So in the last video, we have already told that when we create any string object, then it gets stored in the heap memory or the string constant pool depending on how we are making the string object. You know that there are two ways to make a string object, right? String literal and using the new keyword. For now, we are going to make use of string literals. So suppose within the main method, if you write this particular instruction string s1. So we have written this instruction string s1 is equals to tih. So how it will impact the memory area? Now once you write this string s1 is equals to tih, a object of tih will be created in the string constant pool if it already does not exist. And as we see in the string constant pool on the right side of the screen, we do not see any object tih. So one object will be created and that object will be referred by this variable s1. So now you can see that object tih is created and it is being referred by a variable which is named s1, right? Now what will happen if we create one more object using string literal and instruction like this, string s2 is equals to tih. Now what do you think? A new object will be created for this one? Do you think a new object will be created for this instruction that we have written on the second line within the main method? Do you think? No. In this case, what will happen is, as we have already told, that whenever any string object is created using string literal, whenever any string object is created using string literal, what happens is it first checks in the string constant pool whether that object already exists. So in this case, what will happen? As we write this second line, it will check whether this tih, a object having the value tih, already exists in the string constant pool or not. And we will find that yes, this object already exists. So in this case, it will find that a object already exists in the string constant pool. So what will happen? It will not create a new object. Rather, this s2 variable will also refer to the same object. That same object will be shared by two references. How? Like this, as you are saying in the screen. So now what will happen? That s1 and s2 are sharing the same reference, right? So in this way, what happens? It does not create duplicate object unnecessarily if it already exists in the string constant pool. Now suppose again someone writes string s3 is equals to tih, same will again happen, right? A new object will not get created, rather it will see that tih already exists. So s3 variable will again also point to the same tih object that is in the string constant pool. See, now three references are pointing to the same object, so it is saving the memory, right? It is not creating unnecessary object and just occupying the memory space, which will help other objects which are important to be created in the memory area. And this is also serving the purpose for these three strings that are created without hampering the normal flow, right? So this is where string helps to utilize memory efficiently. So this is one way of utilizing string memory efficiently. Now there is more possibilities of utilizing the memory efficiently, something like this. For example, now we try to modify any one of the object that we have created. For example, let's see that we want to modify the reference S1. So now what we are doing, we are writing another line, string S4 is equals to S1 plus video. So what this will do, this will append the value video to this TIH, and we will get output something like this, right? And now, do you think the original string is modified? That means this one. So this is not the case, right? The original string is never modified. We have already explained where we told you why string is called immutable, because the original object is never modified. Rather, whenever any operation is performed on the original object, a new object is created. So TIH video will be created and it will be checked in the string constant pool whether this exists or not. And if it does not exist, then a new object will be created in the string constant pool. Something like this. TIH video will be created and S4 will refer to that TIH video. So now S4 is pointing to the TIH video and a new object is created. And suppose after that, what we do is we write S4 is equals to TIH again. So that means we are overriding the value of S4 over here in the next line and saying that, okay, I don't need this one, I need TIH only. So what will happen? Now again, S4 will check that, okay, TIH already exists. So I don't need to create a new object. Rather, I will just point to the already existing object. And now S4 will not refer to TIH video and the link will be broken from TIH video. See, the link is now broken and what will happen? S4 will start pointing to TIH. So S4 is also now pointing to TIH. And now what happens is this TIH video that we created, it is lying unreferenced. So now TIH video is lying unreferenced. And as it is lying unreferenced, so it is eligible for garbage collection once the garbage collector runs, and it is allowed to claim this object and remove it from the string constant pool. Thus, any unreferenced object, remember, when number of programmers are working, they create lot of objects. So here what is happening is any unreferenced object which is occupying unnecessary space and is lying in the constant pool or heap area for a longer time, they are removed by the garbage collector and thus freeing up the space in the memory. And thus this also helps to efficiently utilize the memory area, right? Hope you have understood this one. So let's check the second pointer about how string immutability is important or what purpose it serves. So second pointer says that string immutability helps in providing or enhancing the security of the application. We generally know that string is used to store the values of username, password or key in the map. And as you know, these are some important things which should not change or should not be interfered with, otherwise the application will not be able to log in correctly, or if key is changed, then the correct value will not be fetched from the map, right? So for the understanding how this string immutability helps in enhancing the security, we will again check the same example that we have seen earlier. That means we have string S1 to S4 still here and they are referring to the same object TIH, right? So suppose there was another application whose name is, let's suppose app1, and if string was not immutable, remember we are checking the case for string not immutable. If string was not immutable, then what would have happened? So there was application which was also referring to TIH, something like this, and as a result, this P will refer to the same object that we are seeing on the screen. So this P is also referring to the same object TIH. But now later what happened is, later the password for this got changed to, suppose TIH S got added to the password. So P is equals to TIH plus S became the new password for this app 1. But for these applications with reference S2, S4, the password still is TIH. But what happened here, since string was not immutable, so as a result, this modified the value of the original TIH object and the new value became TIHS, and this modified value is shown on the screen. So now you can see the value is modified as TIHS, and as a result, what will happen is this application will be able to log in because its password got changed to this one and it is getting the correct value from the object. But as a result of this modification, what will happen is these references S1 to S4 will start failing. So they will not be able to log in because their password still is TIH, but they are getting the password as TIHS, which is not the correct password for them. As a result, all the application having reference this one, S1 to S4, will fail, and thus this modification impacted the whole application and the security got violated. But now this would have happened if string was not immutable. Remember, not. Now you know that string is immutable, so just cross this not, and now we are checking the case where string is immutable. So since string is immutable, you all now know that what will happen. Since this modification will create a new object TIHS, and it will check in the string constant pool whether this object exists or not, and if it exists, what will happen? It will create a new object and P will start referring to this object without modifying the actual or original value that was there. So this will look something like this. So now P will start referring to TIHS and it will not modify the original value, that is, it will remain TIH. As a result, this login for S1 to S4 will also be successful. That means it will be able to log in because now they will be getting the same password, that is TIH, which they needed, and the new application app 1 had the password as TIHS, so it is referring to object that has the password value as TIHS. So this will also be able to log in, and other applications will also be able to log in without any problem. So this is where string immutability becomes really important. And there is another point. So string immutability helps class loader to load correct class. How? This is also associated to the issue we have seen over above. Suppose you have created a class whose path is something like this, com.pack.tih.java. Now during class loading, the class loader calls this, and these class names are generally served as string to class loader. Now if it was not immutable, someone would have changed the original value to something like this, com.hack.tih.java, and as a result, since this value would have been changed, now the class loader would not get the original class, rather it will get the hacked class, and this hacked class may have a virus or some other prank that the hacker may have created for you, so that your application faces the issue, and as a result, this class loader will not be able to load the correct class if string was not immutable. Since string is immutable, so this refers to the original value rather than any hacked value, and thus string immutability also helps to load the correct class. So hope you have understood this concept, and if you have really enjoyed this video and has got some knowledge from it, then please don't forget to subscribe our channel, because it serves as a motivation to us and it will help us to bring more beautiful videos for you in the future. Till then, keep learning, keep enjoying. Thank you.